Good morning, students. Hope all are doing good at home. And I hope that you have written the question answer which I have given in the previous session. Book exercise and question answer, it is there on the school website. Please download the question answer from the school website and write down in your copy. Okay? So today we will start the new chapter. And what is the name of our chapter? What is the name? Yes, you are right. Evolution of Communication. Now, we will study Lesson 5, Evolution of Communication. What is the meaning of communication? I think that in class 3, you have studied about the communication. Now, sending and receiving messages is called communication. Yes. And what is the meaning of evolution? In the first chapter only I told you the meaning of evolution. Now, that is the process of change. Yes. So, in this chapter, we will study how the changes occur in communication. So, before I give my explanation, let's read the chapter first. Okay? So, let's read the chapter. Evolution of communication. Communication is sending and receiving messages. In the beginning, early humans used gestures to communicate. Gesture means sign language. Okay, they are using the sign language. Okay, they also use a smoke signal and as danger alert. Later, early humans drew picture on the walls of the cave to express themselves. Many caves in Bhimbetka, Madhya Pradesh, okay, have cave paintings made by early humans. Although this form of expressing ideas was easy to understand, it took a great amount of time. With the time, early humans began to use symbols for word and sound. This is how first alphabet came into being. Need for writing. Increasing trade and commerce between distant places made it necessary for people to communicate with others living in different places. It also became necessary to maintain records for the goods traded. This led to the invention of writing. The earliest form of writing developed in the Bronze Age. Clay tablets, about 5,000 years old, have been found in Mesopotamia, present-day Iraq. These are among the earliest written records. Next, the pigeon post. Soon people realized that sending messages to distant places was not easy. Messages could be sent and received only as fast as a man or a horse could run. About 3,000 years ago, long before the arrival of the postal service, homing pigeon means they trained the pigeons, okay? Homing pigeons were used to deliver messages. The messages were tied to the leg of a pigeon, which would then fly off to deliver the message. Homing pigeons were selected because of their natural ability to find their way back home across long distance. The pigeon post became so successful that it was used to carry urgent messages during battle. The postal service. Scholars believe that the first postal service began in ancient Persia, present-day Iran. The Persian ruler improved roads so that message could be delivered swiftly. Posting stations were built where men and horses would wait for the information to be carried to the next station. The ancient Romans perfected the postal system. Indian rulers
also developed a postal system. The postal system was modernized during the 19th century. Today, postal service is widely used means of communication. People send letters and parcels through post office. The cost of sending letters is paid through stamps. So, this is all about the topics which we have to cover today. Okay, now I will explain the chapter. So, here you have seen the evolution of communication. So, here we are having some. This is about the communication, the process where one person is expressing his or her ideas and the other one is listening to the ideas being expressed by the one who is talking. Okay, this is called the communication. Communication is the process where one person is expressing his or her ideas and the other one is listening. Okay. Now, in this chapter, these all are the key concepts, the topics which we have to cover in this chapter. Okay. Now, which are the? They are need for writing, use of pigeons, okay, postal service, invention of telephone and telegraph, printing press, computers and satellite. These are the key concept we have to cover in this chapter. Okay. Now, let's see the first topic, that is the need for writing. Okay. Before that, I will tell you how the people started communicating with each other. Okay. Now, communication is a sending and receiving messages. Already I told you in the beginning, early human use gesture to communicate. Okay. So, gesture means, what is the meaning of gesture? Gesture means that people, they are using the sign language. Okay. To move the hands to express an ideas or feeling. Gesture means to move your hands to express an ideas or feeling, that is known as a gesture. So, early humans, because they don't have any languages to express their feelings, okay? I already told you they are living in a group. So, in the group, if they one people has seen the animal, okay? So, how this people inform to the other members of the group? To inform others, they have made some sign language, okay, that the gesture. So, like that, they communicate with each other. They also used a smoke signal as a danger alert. So, they are using the smoke signals like this here. You can see this is smoke signals, okay. Like this, they raises the smokes and this smokes. By seeing this smokes, the other people, they came to know that, okay, now in the other group or in that areas, the people, they are in danger. So, when they were in a danger, they are just giving a signal through the smoke, okay. After that, later, early human started drawing a picture on the wall of the caves to express themselves. So, this with the help, here you can see the smokes. Here you can see the early humans, they rises the smoke, okay? So, early humans drew pictures on the wall of the caves to express themselves, okay? So, many cave paintings, the archaeologists, they found many cave paintings, okay? And these, through these cave paintings, the archaeologists, they came to know the story of the early humans, okay? So, they drew the picture on the wall of the cave to express themselves, how they hunt the animal, what they are doing in the rest of the time when they are not hunting the animal, how they cook the food, all that scenes they are drawn on the picture on the wall. Here you can see some paintings were there of the early human. Here you can see the paintings of the early humans. Okay, like this type animal painting, hunting scene, they are painted on the wall gates. Okay. Although this form of expressing ideas was easy to understand. As example, I gave you, in your house, the small babies were there. They don't know how to talk, na? 1 year, 2 year babies, they don't know how to talk, but they know how to express their feelings. If they feel thirsty, they want, if they want to drink the water, they are showing some, they indicate that they want to drink the water. If they are hungry, they started crying, and with that cry, we came to know that okay, the baby is hungry or baby want to sleep. So they are giving some sign. They are giving some indication that okay, what they want to exactly what they want. Okay, so like that only the early humans also, they are doing all these things, and it is very easy to understand to the one person to another person. Okay, now early humans began to use symbol for words and sounds. Okay, for words and sounds, they are using some symbols. Okay, and like this, the first alphabet came into being. Like this, they started writing the alphabets. Okay, now the first point, that is the need for writing. What is the need for writing? Now, increasing trade and commerce. In the previous chapter, evolution of transport, I already told you the explorers, they explore many places. Now when they explore the places, they started doing the business also. No? So they are doing the business, and they need some amount also, something or something to note down also. As example, when mummy want to mummy asks to daddy to bring something from the market, and number of things were there. So what papa said? Papa said, please write down all these things in a paper and then give it to me, then only I will purchase, otherwise I will forgot the things. Okay, so mummy write all the things in the list. Mummy has written 9 to 10 things, and mummy handed over to the father. Okay, and father go and purchase all the things. Okay, so need of writing. Why? Because in the past time, they forgot what they want to do and what things they have to purchase, or how much things they have to purchase, they forgot. So it needs the writing. As example, I gave you now question answers. Okay, now if I ask you, then okay, learn the question answer, and you're not writing the question answer in your copy, you have to only learn the question answer. Okay, now you learn the question answer, it is there in your mind. 1 month, 1 week, 2 week, 3 week, and 1 month, it will be there in your mind. But later on, what happened? Slowly, slowly, the answers were just some words are missing, some letters are missing, and slowly you forgot the answer. But if you have written the answer in your copy, then what happened? If you need to see the answer, if you forgot that answer, you can open that answer lesson and you can read that answer again. So same like that, they need the writing. Increasing trade and commerce between distant places, different places, okay, made it necessary for people to communicate with other living in the different places. This led to the invention of writing. And like this, on the clay they are writing. See, this is a clay, this type of clay they are writing. Okay, so here, the increasing trade and commerce between distant places made it necessary for people to communicate with other living in different places. It is also became necessary to maintain records for the goods traded. Means what things they have traded. Means what in the business, what things they have import or export. That also they have to write down. Because of all these things, they need the invention of writing. Okay, these all things need the invention of writing. Okay, the earliest form of writing developed in the Bronze Age. Which age? Already I explained in the Bronze Age, na? Clay tablet, about 5,000 year old, have been found in Mesopotamia. Here you can see clay. In this, they are writing. This type of clay, they are writing and they are sending to one place to another what they have import and what they have exported. Okay. Now coming to the next. That is the pigeon post, or you can say the horse. Before the pigeon post, the people, they use the man or the horse to send the letters. Okay, nowadays, how we are sending the letters? We are sending the letters through the, in our mobile phone, the message is there, or WhatsApp is there, through that, or messengers are there. If we want to communicate with, if we want to send the message to one person or to our friends, we have to only open the WhatsApp or Messenger. We type the message and we send it, and immediately the other person get the message. But today we are doing. In the past time, it is not like that. No? Past time, if they have to communicate, they have to write down the letter. Ask your grandparents, they will tell you. Postal system is there, they are writing the letters. No mobile phone is there, okay? So they are writing the letters and they are going to the post office, post the letter, and after several days, another person, they got the, received the letter, okay? So before this postal system, before that, the people, how they communicate? Because the one person is living in one country, another one is living in another country. How they communicate? No telephone, nothing, no mail, no computer is there. So how they will communicate? They will communicate through the letters, and that letters, they hand it over to the man or the horse. That on the man horse, they are riding on the horse and they are sending the letters with that man or the people who are riding the horse. Like that, they communicate with each other. Okay, so people realize that sending messages to distant places was not easy that time, no? Because far off places, this aeroplane or all that train systems are not good, routes are not good. Okay, so it is very difficult, it is not easy. Messages could be sent and received only as fast as a man or a horse could run, because they were also tired, they also need rest. So in between the way, if they are taking rest, it take much time. Okay, so the message could be sent or received only as fast as a man or horse can run, but they are a living being, they need rest, so it could take time. Okay, so it is not very easy process. Okay, about 3000 years ago, long before the arrival of the postal service, homing pigeons were used to deliver messages. What is this homing pigeon? Homing pigeon means a pigeon that is trained to return home. So in the early time, the people, they trained the pigeon to return home. They just tie the letter, which letter they want to deliver, they, which letter they have to send. They tied the letter on the leg of the pigeon and sent the pigeon. And that pigeon just drop the letter or deliver the letter, and after that return back to home. This type of pigeons were known as a homing pigeons. Okay, so the message was tied to the leg of a pigeon, which would then fly off to deliver the message. Homing pigeons were selected because of their natural ability to find their way back home across long distance. They are roaming here and there, but they return back home. So that is why they selected the pigeons only. Why they selected the pigeons? Because it is the ability found in the pigeons that they find their way back home across the long distance. Crossing the long distance, they return back home. Okay, so this is the ability of the pigeon. So that is why they select the pigeon to deliver the message. The pigeon post became so successful that it was used to carry urgent messages during battle, when there is a fight between one country or to another country, if the battle time is there, that time they are using the pigeons to deliver the message. After that, they, here you can see pigeons. It is used to homing pigeons to carry messages. Pigeons were effective as messengers due to their natural homing ability. The pigeons were transported to a destination in cages where they would be attached with the message, and then naturally the pigeon would fly back to its home where the owner could read his mail. Pigeons have been used to great effect in military situation, the evolution of communication. Okay, this is the pigeons, trained the pigeons. Okay, now coming to the next topic, that is the postal service. Okay, after the pigeons, the scholars believe that the first postal service began in ancient Persia. Present day, it is known as Iran. Ancient time, it was known as Persia. The Persian ruler improved roads so that messages could be delivered swiftly. Okay, so what the Persian rulers improve the roads. Why they improve the roads? They improve the road that the messages could be delivered easily, swiftly, smoothly. Okay. Posting station were built where men and horses would wait for the information to be carried to the next station. Okay. Now trains were there. They are using the trains to send the parcels, to send the letters. Okay. So the posting stations, they build the posting stations where the men, like postmen, okay, and the horses, they were waiting. And from the posting station, they are waiting there and they receive the information and take that information, carry the information to the next station. As example, I gave you. From here, if you are sending the message to the person who is living Golghar, okay. Now, just as an example, I gave you, okay. Now you gave the message to a man or the horse, okay, and send that man to the Asuran Chowk, okay. That person knew the road how to go to the Asuran Chowk. When he reached the Asuran Chowk, after that, he take the another person who is standing there. He take the information from the men and again he started walking through the Golghar. So from Asuran Chowk to the Golghar, the other person they have taken. So stoppages were there. Stoppage were there. Okay, so they built the stoppage. So one person from here, from your house to this Asuran, he take that message information, and from Asuran Chowk to Golghar, another person took that information. So like that they have made the stoppage. Okay, like that they send the information, like that they send the messages. Okay, in the ancient Romans perfected the postal system. Later on, the Romans, they do some improvement in the postal system. Indian ruler also developed a postal system. Later on, the Indians also, their Indian rulers also, they improved the, they also developed or improved the postal system. The postal system was modernized during the 19th century. Later on, when they invented the train, then only postal system was improved, and they started sending the parcels and the letters or the messages through the trains. Before that, they are using the horse or the men to deliver the message. Okay, today postal service is widely used means of communication. Nowadays the people, they are using the mails and electronic mails, emails, and WhatsApp and Messenger, or through the normal text they are doing it. But official letters, they are using the postal service. Courier persons, through the courier they send the letters. people send letters and parcels through post office. Okay, after that, after the 19th century, people can send the letters and the parcels through the post office. The cost of sending letter is paid through stamps. The stamps were there, and through that stamps, they put the stamps on that and they send the letters. Okay, so like this, the evolution of communication. Here you can see now, in the past time, what happened? Early humans, how they communicate? Through the gesture, through the sign language. Okay, later on, what happened? After that, they using the smoke. If they were in danger, they use the smoke signal. Then later on, they started writing. They need of writing, so they started writing on the clay. Okay, then after that, they send the, because they already find out the different places, so they started sending the letters, or for the trade or for the business, if they want to communicate, they are writing through that clay. They are writing and they are sending through the men or the horse. Then later on, they use the pigeons, and after that, the postal service. Okay, now that is all for today's session. Now I will show you some question answer. As you have written some question answers in your copy, so same like that only you have to write. You have to write down the date. You have to write down the lesson number 5. Then lesson name, evolution of communication. Then after that, answer these question you have to write. All these you have to write with a black pen. And then you have to write down the questions. Now I will show you the questions. Here, answer these questions in that. Question number 1. How did early humans communicate? Answer 1. Early humans used gestures to communicate with each other. I'll repeat the question, and question you have to write with a black pen. Don't forget to write with a black pen, okay? Write the question with a black pen, and answers you have to write with a blue pen. Question 1. How did early humans communicate? Answer 1. Early humans used gestures to communicate with each other. Question number 2. What circumstances led to the invention of writing? Answer 2. Increasing trade and commerce between distant places and maintained records for good traded led to the invention of writing. I'll repeat the question. What circumstances led to the invention of writing? Answer 2. Increasing trade and commerce between distant places and maintained records for good traded led to the invention of writing. So only 2 question answer I will give you today. Okay, rest of the book exercise and question answer we will do in the next session. These 2 question answers were not there in your school website. When I will complete my lesson, then I will just then you can download from the school website. Okay, then you can see all these question answers all together in your school website. Okay, I think you have written the answer. If you have not written the answer, no problem. Next time you can download from the school website and complete it. And please, children, complete your notes. Okay? Otherwise, altogether, if you have started writing, it is a big problem for you. So please write down. Start writing. If you are not writing, please start writing. And please write with a neat and clean handwriting. Okay? That's all for today's session. Thank you.